everybody. Welcome back to another awesome day, another awesome vlog. Some of you may not know that I manage one of the largest law firms in the Temecula area. And because of that, I am part of the hiring process for positions from the receptionist to the legal file clerks to paralegals to attorneys. In the interview process and being on the hiring side, I have learned a lot of information about what's important when you are preparing for and attending an interview, especially in a professional office. So I would like to share with you some really important tips so that you can nail your next interview. Let's get started. Before I tell you my tips, I want to show you what it looks like outside. It's been raining all day and there is the most beautiful double rainbow, and I want to show you, I got a really quick clip of it.
There's a complete rainbow. There's actually a double one. All the way.
The first thing I want to tell you before you go into any interview is psych yourself up to be confident. No matter what the position is, no matter what your experience going into it is, be confident that you are the perfect applicant for this position and that you are ready to fill it exactly as they need. The other thing is, before you go into any interview, you should look into the business that you're going to meet with. You should have a little bit of information about what they do, what's important to them, and a little idea about how this business runs. Most places have websites these days, and it's really easy to go online, learn about the business. Sometimes they even have information about the employees that work there and the type of work that they do. That's helpful when you go into an environment to feel more comfortable and more confident for the interview that you are attending. Usually one of the first questions in an interview is, tell me a little bit about yourself. That doesn't mean tell me about your personal life and your personal story. It's regarding the job that you are interviewing for, your skills, and what you have to bring to the table as far as this position and this job is concerned. The employer is looking for a little bit of information about your employment history, your schooling and education, and anything that you feel about yourself that's important for them to know. This is your time to shine. Tell them a little bit about yourself and the skills that you would bring to this position so that they think of you when they're reviewing all of the applicants that they have met with. You want to be the one that they remember. Make sure you dress and look professional. People are going to be impacted the first moment that they see you. Make sure that you're smiling, dressed appropriately. Make sure that you are wearing clothing that is professional, not anything too low cut. The other thing is, if you're going into a professional environment and you have tattoos, if you're going in for an interview, cover up your tattoos to the best of your ability. If you're offered the position, you can then talk to them about that and see what their policy is about tattoos showing in the workplace. Something very important that most people won't think of if they don't have any type of allergies or have anyone in their household with any type of allergies is perfume, lotion, and cologne. When you're going into an interview, you should not wear any perfume, cologne, anything that has a very, very heavy smell, or any smell at all. The reason for that is people in office spaces, especially when you're working closely, a lot of people have allergies these days. And if you're meeting with someone that has an allergy like that, that may turn them off immediately, because if they're concerned about having to ask you to cut down on your perfume use, that could get a little bit uncomfortable. When you're going into any type of interview, you want to make the meeting and the situation as comfortable as possible for everyone in the meeting, especially because you want them to consider you for this position and you want them to think that you are the perfect fit. If you've had any periods of unemployment, just be prepared to discuss them. There are reasons that people don't work for periods of time. Sometimes women who have children will stay home for a while to stay with their children and raise them, but sometimes there are other reasons. Sometimes you're going back to school for a little while. Sometimes you just can't find a job because there aren't jobs available in your field, but you've made an attempt to look and have been trying, and in the meantime, maybe you've been trying something different, like self-employment, but make sure that if you have any periods of unemployment, you are prepared to explain them so that the employer doesn't have any concern about why you had long periods of not working. Another thing you need to be prepared to explain is if you move around from job to job a lot. When people are interviewing, they want someone who is stable and who wants to stay in this position long term. The interviewing process is not fun for employers. It takes time out of their day, and they don't want to feel like they're hiring someone who just in another couple of months may move on to another position. If you've moved around a lot from job to job, there could be reasons for that, and you just need to be ready to explain that in a confident way so that they understand that you want this position and you want to stay there long term. The other question you need to be ready to answer, if you are currently employed, most employers want to know why you're leaving that job. So just be ready to explain that. There are several reasons to leave jobs. First of all, to try something new, or if you're looking for some sort of growth and you feel like the job that you're at right now, you've reached your potential there and there's no room for growth, there are plenty of reasons to leave and move on from one employer, but you should have that prepared and be ready to answer that question in a confident way. Make sure you're on time for your appointment. You don't need to be there too early, but make sure that if you haven't ever been to this location before, that you make sure to give yourself enough time to get there, park, and get familiar with your surroundings so that when you go in, you feel comfortable with where you are, but don't be late. That is a very bad sign when employers are interviewing, because if you're going to be late to an interview when you are on your best behavior, they're going to believe that there's a good chance you're going to be late to work on a regular basis. But don't get there too early either. It's never a good sign when you have an appointment scheduled at 2 o'clock and you show up at 1:15 and want to sit and wait in the lobby. That makes employers feel like you're not paying attention to the time, you weren't clear maybe on when you scheduled your appointment, and you want to make sure that the employer knows that you're good with your scheduling, organization, and calendaring. So being a few minutes early, 10 to 15 minutes at the most, would be just fine, but make sure you are not even a minute late. Also, when you're late, that can make you frazzled. If you're running through the door trying to get there on time and you're not comfortable with your surroundings, that is not a good way for you to start your confident interviewing process. The last tip that I have for you is to make sure that you know the salary that you're looking for. Sometimes employers will ask that, and the people that are being interviewed say that they're open and that they don't have a salary in mind. Most of the time, that's absolutely untrue. Everyone has a salary in mind. Everyone knows what they want to make. If you aren't familiar with what this job should pay, before you go into the interview process, do a little research. Look into it. Have an idea of what jobs in this area with this position pay. And also have an idea of what you need and what you're looking for. You can give a range. You can also explain if this is a new position to you and you have a lot to learn in order to move up in this business. You can explain that since you're starting out and you're new to the position, you understand that you'll be starting on the lower end and that you anticipate that with your hard work, you'll be able to earn a little bit more over the next couple of years. But you should have an idea and have a number in mind to share with them. There are people that would potentially be started at one point in the position and at another point, depending on what they need, what they're looking for, and what their level of experience is. But if you at least give them an idea of what you want, that helps them make a decision if you're the one they choose for the job. I hope you enjoyed my video. I hope you learned something. People are constantly interviewing for jobs and a lot of them are unprepared. So I hope that these tips were helpful for you. Don't forget to smash the thumbs up button and don't forget to subscribe.